تفضل شيخ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Today is Monday 18th of Jumada الأول 1444 and it is the 12th of December 2022. I just buried, we just buried my beloved mother. May Allah جل وعلا have rahma on her. سبحان الله. She used to teach the Quran and she used to love the Quran. And I remember that she is the one who taught me Ayat al-Kursi. May Allah Jalla wa'ala make this in her scale in the day of resurrection. May Allah Jalla wa'ala make her firm in answering the questions of the angels now, because this night is the first night for her in the grave. May Allah Jalla wa'ala make this night as the best of her nights. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. Please make dua for her. And jazakumullah khairan for the brothers and sisters from everywhere who called to give their condolences. And I really apologize. I could not answer many of your calls. May Allah Jalla wa'ala reward you. I just have a very quick message to you, my dear brothers and sisters. If you have a parent, a mother or a father, please, please, I beg you. To look after them, to look after them. Because now I have no father, no mother. I lost both of them. And wallahi, although my mother was very ill, hardly talking to us, yet her presence between us is worth the entire dunya. And now both has gone. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the parent is the biggest gate to Jannah. Al-walidu awsatu abwab al-Jannah means the biggest gate to Jannah. That big gate, I don't want to say that it was closed, but maybe it was partially closed because they are not in front of us. However, it is still open for us to have kindness to them, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us after their demise. But we don't want for them to pass away and then we start being kind to them. We need to be kind to them in this dunya. And my dear brothers and sisters, please, especially young people living in the West, wallahi, I feel sorry for you, because you really don't understand the value of a father, the value of a mother. And I am telling you, subhanallah, I found that the most successful people are those who are successful and kind to their parents. Subhanallah. And I don't want to say that as a general rule. Let us say it, most of the successful people are kind to their parents in general. May Allah Jalla wa'ala make us among those who are kind to our parents. I remember that a man came to Ibn Abbas and he said to him, I killed someone and I want to repent. How can I repent? Look at this. He killed someone. Allah Jalla wa'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمُ خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعَنَهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. Subhanallah. Despite this, Ibn Abbas told him, do you have a mother? He said, yes. He said, then look after her. That might be a way to repent to Allah Jalla wa'ala. Imagine this, my dear brothers and sisters. One man came to Ibn Umar and he said, listen, my mother cannot do the toilet except if she is sitting on my back. Yeah, look at this. Have I fulfilled her rights? He said, you haven't fulfilled any of her rights. Let alone that you fulfilled her rights. Please, my dear brothers and sisters, before you lose them, fix your relationship, especially young people living in the West. Yes, so many young people come to me and they say that they have problems with their parents. Please fix it, because once you miss them, you miss them forever while in this dunya. Subhanallah. My mother was very ill. Allah honored me by coming to be with her. A few days before However, subhanAllah, on the day she passed away, yesterday, within seconds, we lost her. Within seconds, we lost her, subhanAllah. It was very smooth, very quick, subhanAllah. It is a matter of second. I used to have a mother, and then after that, no mother, no mother, no father. Please, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, look after your parents. Allah Jalla wa Ala will give you tawfiq through your parents, and have sabr, have sabr. Remember, Allah Jalla wa Ala, all Allah Jalla wa Ala in many verses in the Quran combined between his rights and the rights of the parents. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَأَنِشْكُرْ لِي. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, be thankful to me. And then after that, to who? وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ. And you will go back to me, إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. Those brothers who lost their parents, I strongly advise to give sadaqah and to include them in your dua every day. And try to give sadaqah on a daily basis. And whenever you give sadaqah, include them and make dua for them. If you were not kind, see the mercy of Allah Jalla Ala. If you were not kind to them while they were dead, if you were not kind to them when they were alive, then you can still be Allah kind Allah to them Allah after Allah their death, because there is Allah nothing Allah called I lost hope. Allah Jalla Ala always gives us hopes, not just hope, hopes. And Allah Jalla Ala gives us chances. Jazakumullahu khairan. This is Jeddah. This is where we buried my mother. And 7 years ago, we buried my father. May Allah Jalla Ala have rahmah on him. Jazakumullahu khairan. Again, Jazakumullahu khairan for all the brothers and sisters who send messages, who try to call. And I do apologize for being unable to answer your calls. Jazakumullahu khairan.